Hi, I'm Dr. Joy Harden Bradford, and I'm sitting one-on-one with Shay Rodriguez. I am a licensed psychologist and the founder and creator of Therapy for Black Girls. Therapy for Black Girls is an online platform designed to make mental health relevant and accessible to Black women and girls across the country. The platform includes a directory where you can find a therapist in your city or state. It also includes the platform for my podcast as well as blog posts.
Dr. Joy, thank you so much for being here with me today.
You're welcome. I'm happy to be here.
Yes, of course. Your site, Therapy for Black Girls, you are the creator and founder. But what I feel like is so important about your site is that it's taking something that could be taboo in our community for Black women to go see therapy, and you're like making it okay and super accessible to everyone in the United States, because it is literally just a guide for them, a guide, a directory. It's like enabling them just with a click of their fingers with their smartphones to find someone. Mm-hmm. I've gone on the site a couple times myself to find someone to speak with. What gave you the idea that we needed as Black women, and I see even some doctors on your site work with Black males. Mm-hmm. What gave you the idea that we needed that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I think I continue to see the same conversations on social media around people saying like, oh, I'm looking for a Black woman therapist. I'm looking for a Black woman therapist. And I feel like we recommend like our hairdressers or our makeup artists like very easily.
We do.
But sometimes there's still the taboo around therapy, right? And so you might not want to share that you're in therapy. So when I continue to see those conversations, I thought, oh, this feels like something that we need. Mm-hmm. So it started by me just kind of putting out a call saying, if anybody has had a really great therapist that they've worked with, nominate them and I will compile it into a directory
so
across
states.
So
you like went on Twitter, went on Facebook?
And yeah, I just put a call out and I think I got like 90 people, what? 90 therapists nominated in like the first week.
Like,
yeah.
That's crazy. Yeah. That's amazing, but yeah. That's kind of like... It's crazy to think, because we're always so guarded, you never would think, but maybe with social media it makes people be like, oh, well, I will never see these people, so I'll
Right, and it was an anonymous form, so it was just a link to a Google Doc. So people, you know, nobody knew that you were nominating and you didn't have to attach your name to it, so they were just nominating their therapist.
Okay.
So from that, I got a very nice start, and then once other therapists saw it, they wanted to include their names and their practices as well. So that is what grew the directory to its current version, which is, I probably have over 500 therapists across the country listed now.
How do you go about vetting those therapists? Like making sure that they're legit?
Mm-hmm. So they are required to share their license information. So I do a quick search just to kind of make sure that they're in active standing with their state boards. But there also is a disclaimer on the site for you to make sure that you check to, you know, double check probably to make sure that the person is in good standing and doesn't have any like issues with their disciplinary boards or anything like that.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Was there ever any pushback in the mental health community that, you know, you were creating this site? Where did therapists of different colors ever say anything in regards to not feeling included on the site?
There has been a little bit of pushback. I mean, you know, and I think that happens with anything,
of
right?
Course,
like
yeah.
that there are going to be people who feel like, oh, well, why do they need this? And why are we always segregating? That kind of thing. But more than anything, it has been like overwhelmingly positive feedback from both other mental health therapists as well as just, you know, people who are not therapists. It's been a lot of support and positive feedback.
That's amazing. Dope. I love that. You watch TV?
Tons of it, probably more than I should.
Jay-Z, Insecure, so many people have kind of thrown out there that they have gone to seek mental help for their mental health. Like, what do you think about that? How does that make you feel? The fact that you created such a resource and now there's like this push in pop culture to seek the help, to be okay with seeking help.
Yeah, I think every time somebody like a Jay-Z or Kendrick Lamar, I think, has mentioned it in some of his songs. Anytime somebody like that comes out to talk about mental health concerns, it's only a positive impact. Because then people can realize, like, oh, it's okay for me to go and talk to somebody who is not a part of my life otherwise, a non-judgmental, objective person, to get some help about, you know, things that I may be struggling with. So whenever we see things like Insecure, you mentioned, when Molly sought therapy, I think all of that just makes it much more normal. Because I think there is still the idea that you have to be crazy, so to speak, to go to a therapist, when really we all have struggles that we could benefit probably from talking to a therapist about. So I just really like that there is more conversation around it, and that people are kind of realizing it's okay to go to therapy.
You know, in Insecure, Molly like talks about speaking with different therapists and like not finding her right fit at first. And like, even though it was kind of put in a comedic way, it's so true. Like, you can go talk to someone and she's like waiting for the time to run out, but then get my insurance paying for this, so I'm gonna stay here. And I just paid this copay, I'm about to stay here. We gonna talk about something.
Yeah.
How would you suggest that somebody really get around that, find their perfect match?
Yeah, and see, that is the downfall sometimes with therapy, because it's a human interaction, right? Like, so when you go to maybe see your OBGYN or whatever, like, you probably want a good relationship, but you're probably not there more than once a year. So if it's a little off, you probably are okay with it. Whereas therapy, we're having a very personal relationship. You're probably sitting with me for 50 minutes to an hour, probably weekly. So it needs to click. It needs to feel like, okay, this feels like somebody I'm comfortable talking with. And so sometimes you will have to go through maybe one or two, maybe three therapist to find somebody who you feel like, okay, this person gets me, and even if I don't feel like comfortable sharing immediately, I could eventually see myself sharing with the person. So you do want to try to vet people to kind of see who's going to be a good fit for you, and sometimes you can tell that through websites. Like, a lot of therapists have videos on their websites, a lot of therapists have podcasts or different kinds of things, they post things on social media, so you can kind of get a sense of maybe somebody's personality in that way. But sometimes you will just have to go to maybe a session or two and talk with the people to kind of see if it's going to be a good fit. And I really would encourage people not to like let that throw them off course, because I think people feel like, oh, I don't want to have to keep sharing this story over with a new person. And I think people think, okay, then it's too much trouble. But if you find a good therapist and a person who's a good match for you, it really can change your life.
What made you start your podcast, Therapy for Black Girls?
I think in the same vein of like wanting to make mental health concerns just very normal, I felt like the podcast was a very good way for me to kind of talk about the issues that I see in therapy and that other therapists see in therapy, and make it in a very relevant way for people to get. So, you know, like mentioning Molly from Insecure. So I had an episode where I was on the podcast with another therapist who talked about, if Molly was my client, this is the kind of thing that I would do with her. These are the kind of treatment plans that I would have with her. So I think when you can talk about like characters from TV, it really makes it so that people can see like, oh, okay, I could go to therapy to talk about something like this.
It's super relatable.
Yeah.
What are you, like, mentioning that you talk to other therapists, do you talk to other therapists to like actually seek help, like actually have a session?
I don't currently have a therapist, but I definitely have. I've had two therapists in the past. I think probably once when I was in grad school and once in my first job. Because like I mentioned, like, we all struggle with stuff. And so I really think it's important for anybody who wants to be a mental health professional to know what it feels like to be on the other side of the couch. So you can kind of really get the experience of like how difficult it could be for somebody to come in and share things with you when they don't know you.
Super difficult, right? And people say that that should be why you're okay with going to therapy, because you're talking to a stranger.
Right. Yeah, like, you're not gonna see me in, you know, in your exercise class probably, or in any other area of your life. And if you do, I'm not going to acknowledge you, right? Like, I'll give you a knowing glance that I know you, but we don't even typically initiate conversation with people who are clients unless you talk to us first. Because your confidentiality is most important, right? Definitely. Like, if you think I'm going home and telling my husband everything that you tell me about, then that makes it so that you don't trust the space that we've created. So even something as small as seeing you in Walmart, like, I wouldn't even say hi to you, because you could be with somebody and then they might ask like, well, who is that? How do you know? And then you've compromised your confidentiality. So unless you speak first, then we typically won't even speak.
I never even thought of that before. That's wild.
Yeah.
Do you think that you, just speaking of like talking with a stranger, like I feel like if I see you, I don't see like a stranger. I see me. Like, do you think that's important? Do you think your image, your fro, your bright colors on your website, the colors that you wear, like, do you think that's important to you as the face of mental health at this point? Do you think that's like a newer face at this point?
I mean, I definitely think it is growing in that direction. I mean, you know, the vast majority of the therapists in the therapist directory are other Black women. And so, you know, I think for somebody to be able to go to the site and see all of these women who look like them maybe in some way is mind-blowing, I think. And I think in some ways that does make it more relatable, right? Because the most important thing that determines whether therapy is going to be successful is the relationship you have with your therapist. So if seeing someone who looks like you feels like it gets you one step closer to actually going to therapy, then by all means, take that step, you know? And I do think that the director really has helped in that way.
Yeah, definitely, definitely. What makes you an innovator, do you think?
I think I really strive to be of service. And then if I see that there's a need that needs to, you know, be addressed, then I try to figure out how I can make it happen. And I, of course, don't always have the answers, right? Like, the first, like, iteration of the directory, like I told you, was a Google Doc. It's much more advanced than that now. And so all the tech stuff and, you know, that felt very overwhelming. But then once I found somebody who could manage that piece and do that piece, you know, I can trust that that person can manage that stuff.
So was it once you realized that the site was working, you were like, okay, I'm going to bring in some people now to actually work on the site and make it better? I know you were you were under construction and you were doing some things on the site, things like that.
Yeah.
But it's after you already saw the initial interest, correct?
Exactly, exactly. Exactly. Yeah. And I mean, what you're talking about, the under construction. So a couple of celebrities have shared the website, Gabrielle Union, Solange, Gabby Sidibe. And so I think when their followers on social media, like, see Therapy for Black Girls, then they all try to go to the site at one time. It has crashed a couple of times because of that. But I've now had to bring on another web person to kind of say, okay, we need to monitor the traffic and, you know, like, allow for the hosting to kind of do what it needs to do to manage, like, that kind of volume.
Did you ever think that you were making, you're going to make this impact with that list?
No, absolutely not. I mean, I thought it would be helpful and I knew that sisters would be able to benefit from it, but I never saw it getting to like the likes of like Solange sharing the site. Like, that's just amazing.
That is amazing. Yeah. I think even Crystal and Kidfiri from The Read like mentioned your site before and
I miss that and I don't even always know when it's shared, you know? So that's the really cool thing that people can just find it.
I love that. Yeah. I love that. Thank you so much for sitting down with me today. I really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Yes. And that wraps us up for today for this episode of One-on-One with Shay Rodriguez and Dr. Joy.